Joe Diffie, an icon to many country fans for his string of number one hits in the 1990s, has died from complications related to the coronavirus, a spokesperson revealed Sunday afternoon. He was 61.
Today on CountryCast, we have some very unfortunate news to report, and that is legendary 90s country music singer Joe Diffie has passed away at the age of 61 after contracting the coronavirus just yesterday on March 28th. Joe Diffie passed away today, Sunday, March 29th. And this information was, according to The Boot, put out in a press release by Diffie's public relations team, where they said the family is asking for privacy during this time. Again, just yesterday, Diffie was diagnosed with the virus, and he put out a statement saying, "I am under the care of medical professionals and currently receiving treatment. My family and I are asking for privacy at this time. We want to remind the public and all my fans to be vigilant, cautious, and careful during this pandemic." Now, unfortunately, just a day later, after Diffie released that statement telling fans that he, in fact, was diagnosed, we are now reporting that Joe Diffie has passed away at the age of 61. I honestly am just speechless right now. The month of March has not been very kind to the country music community. We know we just lost Kenny Rogers back on March 20th, and now the loss of Joe Diffie. This is definitely a huge impact right now through the country music world. He will greatly be missed. He is a legend. You talk about Pickup Man, John Deere Green, Texas Size, Heartache, Prop Me Up Beside the Jukebox. You name the song Joe Diffie put out, and it was loved by everyone. I mean, all of his songs were hits. And this is definitely a very unfortunate time that we are seeing. And we have lost one of the greatest to do it during the 90s, Mr. Joe Diffie. Our hearts and prayers go out to his family during this time, who are asking for privacy from that PR release for his passing. And we just want them to know that our hearts and prayers go out to them. And this is definitely some very unfortunate times.
Grammy-winning country music legend Joe Diffie passed away today, Sunday, March 29th, from complications of coronavirus COVID-19. The statement read simply, "His family respects their privacy at this time." On Friday, Diffie became the first country star to go public with a coronavirus diagnosis. "I am under the care of medical professionals and currently receiving treatment," a statement attributed to him read. "My family and I are asking for privacy at this time. We want to remind the public and all my fans to be vigilant, cautious, and careful during this pandemic." Diffie, a member of the Grand Ole Opry for 25 years, is a household name to any country fan who came of age listening to the format in the 1990s. He had more than 20 top 10 country hits, 5 of which went to number 1, Home, If the Devil Danced, In Empty Pockets, Third Rock from the Sun, Pickup Man, and Bigger Than the Beatles. 2 of his 13 albums went platinum and another 2 were certified gold.
Little boy walks in with a bloody nose, got beat up on his way home from school. His dad caught him running out the back, tears in his eyes and a baseball bat. Ooh, revenge. He said, "Son, I won't stop you, but before you go, let me tell you a little story about the toughest man I know." They hit him and he just turned cheek. Don't think for a minute he was weak. 'Cause in the end, he showed them he was anything but frail. They hammered him to a cross, but he was tougher than nails. Well, he dropped that bat like it weighed a ton. Father put his arms around his son and said, "Just let it go. Believe me, I've been in your shoes. Had to ask myself, what would Jesus do? Here's what I know. Whenever I'm in doubt, I look up what he said. It's all there in the good book, in black and white and red. It hit him and he just turned the other cheek. Don't think for a minute he was weak. 'Cause in the end he showed them he was anything but frail. They hammered him to a cross, but he was tougher than nails. Yeah, in the end, he showed them he was anything but frail. They hammered him to a cross, but he was tougher than nails. Tougher than names.